The Clean Air Act was established and sets up the National Ambient Air Quality Standards, also known as the NAAQS, and criteria pollutants.
Continuous air monitoring sites, otherwise known as CAMs, can be found across the state. The six criteria pollutants which are monitored include ozone, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, lead, and particulate matter. Air monitoring stations are used to collect air quality data. The agency uses this data to make decisions to help protect the public health and environment.
The State of Texas Air Monitoring Network is approximately 230 sites across the state with over 500 individual pollution samplers. The network is owned half by the state of Texas, TCEQ, and the other half is owned by other entities such as universities, local governments, and industries. All of our sites are different, but a common element that you'll see at most of them when you come up to the site is a meteorological tower.
They hold the wind speed, wind direction, and temperature boom to help us collect meteorological data.
The next thing that you might see are continuous particulate monitors and non-continuous. There are also particulate monitors that measure particulate matter 10 microns or less and 2.5 microns or less. If the site has a trailer and you walk inside, then there are some instruments that you'll see on the inside also. We have non-continuous and continuous volatile organic compound samplers. Those are the canister sampler and the automated gas chromatograph. Or there might be gaseous analyzers that measure ozone, nitrogen oxides, carbon monoxide, or sulfur dioxide. An automated gas chromatograph is a continuously running instrument that we use to collect data on 56 individual volatile organic compounds. Canister sampler is a non-continuous instrument that collects a 24-hour sample that's collected by our operators and then sent back to the air lab in TCEQ for analysis. They analyze it for 84 volatile organic compounds.
When choosing a location for a new site, we have to ensure the area is suitable and we are able to get power at the new site.
That means that it's mostly flat and it's not prone to flooding.
There are a number of costs associated with setting up a stationary monitoring site. The site preparation, the cost of the trailer itself, the equipment, and the operational cost, including staff.
It's very important to the TCEQ that our data meet high data quality standards. And the reason is that our data is used to make decisions that impact human health and the environment. TCEQ considers our data near real time. The continuous instruments are collecting data all the time, but there are delays in providing that data to the public due to processing methods.
Stationary air monitoring sites are not intended for emergency use. However, they can be used to contribute to the whole picture.
Our data can provide information about the ambient conditions in the area during that emergency.
We check our instruments regularly to make sure they're working correctly. Quality control checks are performed daily, weekly, and monthly.
We do training annually with all of our operators that can go over current procedures and or new procedures that have come up in the last year. We also do ongoing training depending on new issues that arise during the year.